Hey guys, I'm Malia M, and I'm coming at you with a college life hack for freshmen or for people who are just looking for some tips on college. So let's get into it. Number one, buy a planner. P-L-A-N-N-E-R, planner. I can't stress how important this planner was to me and is to me now. A planner is something that just can save your life in all sorts of ways. I say invest in some planner, some type of planner, and some pens, highlighters, because organization is key in college. There's a ton of due dates back to back, and you just want to be ahead of things before they actually come up. Oftentimes in college, you can get a planner for free. I know personally at my school, in the SAC office, they offer planners, which is like the SGA office, they offer planners there as well. You can find planners for cheap at Walmart, CVS, Target, any other place like that. But a planner is definitely something that could save your life in college, because let me tell you how many times I done forgot about due dates, how many times I done forgot about the syllabus. Like, in the beginning of the semester, when you get all your syllabuses, just write down every deadline, and anytime something comes up, you just add it to your planner. Your planner is like a contract, a binding contract with yourself in school, pretty much, and like all your other fulfillments that you need to complete. Like, a planner is everything. Like, I can't stress enough, just get y'all a planner and y'all see what I'm talking about. Because if you get a planner and write down all your deadlines and all the events that you have to do, there's no reason. Like, a planner could save you a grade, like a letter grade, definitely. So number two is attend class. I understand, like, being in college, it's a breath of fresh air. I know personally for me, like, I used to live with my parents back home, and like in college I have my own apartment now. I live with my roommates. It's just like a ton of new freedom that you never experienced before in life. And sometimes you want to party and go out and can't wake up for class the next day. Yeah, I've been there too. Like, I know. But no matter what, attend class. Even if you have to attend class drunk with a badass hangover, get your ass up and go to class. Like, I can't, like, you can be sleep in class, or you can, well, not sleep, but you can be not paying attention in class, and just by hearing something your professor said can really save you a letter grade on, not a letter grade, but can save you some wrong answers. You paid for them. Just think about it. And let me not be the one to say, because I missed class plenty of times, but I wished I wouldn't have. Because when you miss class, some teachers do things like participation points and attendance. And just being in class makes a whole difference. For instance, like, I had EMC 2130. Like, it's like a English composition class, basically. And at first I hated the class because I thought my teacher was a bitch. I thought she was grading so harshly. And she was a TA. She was like a college student just like me. So I was like, why the heck is she giving me like a B on this fucking paper? Like, it was a B minus, literally. And I thought I worked so hard. Like, I thought I was the bomb, diggity bomb. Boy, I was wrong. Because I got that B minus and I was hurt. I mean, it's a B minus, but I was so hurt because I was just like, I worked so hard. But that class actually challenged me, and I went to class every day because of that. It challenged me, and I actually learned something. I was able to apply it in other classes. Now when I'm writing, I'm always very creative within my writing. So I feel like you should go to class, because you never know what might happen for you in a class. Like, I never thought that I would have fell in love with English composition. Like, that would have been my favorite class last semester. But actually, it was my favorite class. And when you're picking out classes, I mean, you should get classes, because there's like websites like Rate My Professors, you should get classes that are easy for you, but you should try to challenge yourself in some sort of way. So don't get a teacher just because they're easy, because college is an experience. You're paying for all of these things, so you should be trying to get knowledge. You should be trying to obtain something from every class that you're enrolled into. And I wish I would have done that, because I feel like I would have appreciated college a little bit more. I mean, I'm still a sophomore, so I have much more time. But even this semester, I'm appreciating the material of my class more. I know I may sound like a little nerd or whatever you want to say, but it's the truth, because at the end of the semester, when it comes to finals or even quizzes and tests, you'll do so much better. You won't be having to cram. You won't be having to study. I know I was Miss Professional Cram, study the night before the test, stay up 24 hours. I mean, that happens in college. Like, it's going to be some weeks where you're going to be, where's my bed? But, like, if you go to class, it'll just make things 10 times easier. 10 times easier on yourself. Eh, you know. So, number three. Sit it out. One moment. Number three. Network and meet people. That can go piggyback off of going to class. Like, if you go to class, you'll meet people. Like, in college, you need to be trying to meet people, because these people are going to be the next future lawyers, the next future superstars, the next business owners, the next everything. This is the future right here. Like, their classmates are going to be successful, and that's the odds of it all. You're going to meet the people that surround yourself. So, like, go to class, network. You can make study groups. I know I wasn't the most friendliest. Like, I have a couple friends, and I meet people in class. I mean, study groups and stuff like that. But you need to be able to try to retain the friends that you're meeting and join organizations. I know specifically for me, I joined a business fraternity because I am a management and marketing major at my school. So I joined a business fraternity called Delta Sigma Pi, which is a co-ed fraternity. And I met a ton of people, and it was just a great experience for me. So I'd say find something that you're passionate about and join a club and get involved and try to meet new people, especially being a freshman living on campus. That's the perfect time to meet people, because after your second year of college, pretty much everyone moves off campus, and it's harder to meet people because you may just be going to and from school and things like that. So your freshman year is very essential to meet people. And even if you're not a freshman and you live on student housing and things like that, meet your neighbors, get to know the people around you. Like, don't be that girl that's always in their phone. Oops, don't be that girl that's always in her phone. Like, try to get to know people, meet people. That's what college is all about. Number four, budget. Be smart about your money. Be smart about your money, honey. Like, I can't stress, my sisters and my siblings call me El Cheapo. I'm not cheap, but like, I like expensive things, I like nice things, but on top of that, I know how to budget myself. I know how to, some months I can just save every penny, and then some months I can splurge, but I know exactly my limit. Like, some people in college have money, l'argent, whatever you want to say, some people have money in college, so things aren't like that hard for them. Like, they every week they end up with something new or things like that. You need to understand what type of student you are. You need to be understanding your own pockets. Don't watch people pockets. Don't do that type of things. You need to understand what you can afford and what you cannot afford. So budget your money in that type of way. Like, for instance, me, I'm living off campus this semester. I had a full ride scholarship, so I received like housing and things like that paid for by my school. So I basically, in the beginning of the semester, I get a large sum of money back for school. But I understood in the beginning of the semester, well, I know that basically my bills have to be paid. Like, every first of the month, my rent is going to be withdrawn whether the money is there or not. Well, the money has to be there. So the thing is, you have to budget yourself. You need to not go buy your Louis Vuitton bag if you want it, or not go buy a new iPhone 7. You need to know what your pockets are looking like and budget yourself, because money is key. Like, you can't be doing nothing broke to be honest, and you need to open up a savings account, because saving in college is essential. Like, I'm making saving goals for myself. I know personally, like, when I graduate college, I want to have at least like $30,000 saved up. I know it's like a high goal. I'm a college student, but I know like it's attainable for me. Like, if you think about yourself and what's attainable for you, you just say, okay, I want to have $5,000 saved up, $10,000 saved up. But you need to have some money to start off with when you get out of college. So I say, if get a part-time job, start a business.
Know how much money you have coming in every month, and you need to know how to budget that money that you have coming in every month. Don't every time you get $500, or sometimes your parents send you money, or every time you get your paycheck, don't go buy the shoes that you want. Say you put money up. You need to have money for food. You need to make expense accounts. Like, college does have to come to an end. I know you need to be looking at the future, to be honest, because like just last year I was a freshman. Now I'm a sophomore. Next year I'll be a junior, and then the year after that I'll be a senior. And whether I decide to go to grad school or not, I still need to have money to succeed in any endeavor I decide to take on. So I'm budgeting. I say split your money up into three. Have an account which you can just spend sometimes freely, and then have an expense account. I know with SunTrust personally, I open three bank accounts. I have my Aaliyah checkings account, Aaliyah expense account, which all my bill money stays in that account. Like, I don't touch that account at all. I pretend like it doesn't exist. I just disregard that account. My checking is my money for leisure, like for things like going out, partying, things like that. And then my savings is another account. I have a money market savings account. I don't touch it at all. Like, I pretend like it doesn't exist. What savings? Like, you got money? Nope. If I don't got no money in Aaliyah checking, I ain't got no money. Like, I'm staying home tonight.